Dear Pierce, I enclose your repaired gold spigot pipe and another spigot, which is with my compliments. It was a pleasure to meet you in Antwerp and to hear from the outstanding work you do with pipes, wishing you and yours a very happy Christmas and a peaceful new year. Signed, Tom. Equally, a very happy Christmas to you all. As you can possibly tell, Christmas came a little bit early this year for me. Santa delivered a present that was beyond the call of duty. I'd given my gold spigot to Tom Palmer when I'd met him in Antwerp and said, look, you know, if you could repair this, this would be great. I've tried to repair it myself. I've bought a replacement stem for it. That helped, but you know, it just gurgles like hell. The original, this is the said pipe, the original gold mounting had kind of come loose and I'd re-glued it back on because the join between the stem and the mortise was loose and that had kind of worn and cracked the gold and so, but it gurgled like hell. I mean, that was the biggest problem, this gurgled like hell. And it is my dream pipe. It is, I think, my nicest pipe in my collection. And so it's nice that my dream pipe that I love very much finally smokes like a dream pipe should. Absolutely zero gurgle. So Tom, if you get to watch this outstanding, outstanding quality of service from your company, I'm just completely bowled over and chuffed to pieces. Now, as he also said in the letter, he gifted me, I'm being gifted pipes all over the place here, but he gifted me a silver spigot. A walnut finish silver spigot, no doubt, and a beautiful 408. Not a shape I would have gone for as my first choice, but that makes it even nicer because it's such a beast for smoking. Good thick chunk of wood. It's a real smoker's pipe. I'm absolutely bowled over. Now, he'd said to me, I told him about my YouTube movies and he said, well, I think you deserve at least a pipe for what you do for the industry. So I guess I do. And thank you very much. I'm still bowled over. I said to him, Tom, it's really not necessary. But wow, he delivered. Now, Peterson's repair service is quite well reputed. As are many repair services by leading pipe factories and makers. However, you know, I bought that gold spigot for a fairly big price off ebay.co.uk and, you know, really, I'm not going to send every pipe I have a flaw with that I buy on eBay or from a reputable online seller back to the manufacturer complaining that they didn't make it well in 1981 as this pipe was made in. So please do send back your pipe to the manufacturer if there's an issue there that you cannot fix yourself. But, you know, don't hit Peterson's with a barrage of pipes that you've bought on eBay. I think that would be a little bit out of line. Now, on pipe repair in general, I find that an awful lot of minor flaws in pipes can be fixed simply with a little file like this. Small file for widening drills, drill holes, either in the shank or in the stem, particularly easy if it's a straight pipe. Often, you know, there is quality control in most companies, but you know, we all have a good day and a bad day, so there might be some slight issues on your pipe, and as I said, a little file will usually solve that. Equally, a fantastic thing, an emery board or sandpaper will fix an awful lot of problems. So you can do an awful lot of your repairs yourself. There really is no need to go and send them back. Now, but of course, you know, sometimes you just have to send them back. I had that case with my Paolo Becker and I'd sent it back to him and I've made a film about this in the past and Mr. Becker, a very fine gentleman, said, you know, after a couple of sort of slightly annoyed and irritable sounding emails between the two of us, said, well, actually, I've seen the pipe, and we made some, we had some pre-drilled Cumberland stems. There's a Cumberland stem made in the 80s, and they were badly drilled, and that's the problem. That, so I'm very, very sorry about that. So, you know, even the creme de la creme of artisan pipe makers, like Paolo Becker, which he is one of the finest in the world today, Italian, you know, I like those Italians, you know, he'll admit to his mistakes. I'd sent him €60 and say, please, you know, this is for the cost of the repair and postal. And he sent me back €30 and said, look, I've just taken money out for materials and for post. So, you know, a real, real gentleman, as most of them are, I think. Wonderful, a wonderful result, a wonderful early Christmas present, and as generally the pipe smoking community does for me, it restores my faith in humanity. Outstanding. There are so few, so many companies that offer quality service, and they just do not deliver. The service that you know, they deliver is fantastic. It was so nice of Tom to say to me, you know, you deserve at least a free pipe for what you do for pipe smoking on YouTube. And I'm very flattered that he does that. I mean, that just shows you that really business is about relationships. It is about give and take. On another note, actually, he said to me, if you had told me, he said, 10 years ago, that there was going to be a huge revival in pipe smoking because of the internet, I would have told you you're mad. Well, isn't it funny how technology works? Isn't it funny how times change? Long may it continue to go, you know, this way. Lovely. So that's the pipe repair update. I shall have some photos there for you to see. Christmas came early. I'm very, very happy. On tobaccos, I'll just kind of end on some tobacco. And funnily enough, and it's not a plug, but it is in fact Irish Oak. Now, I bought a tin of this. I bought one tin of this when I first started smoking in the first year. And I found, gosh, it's terrible, I thought. It's far too much like cigarettes. But of course, you know, when I started the pipe, I was still smoking cigarettes, and it took me a while to kind of wean myself off. So I don't smoke cigarettes anymore. And now, I love the fact that this is a very natural tasting tobacco. Tastes a little bit woody. It's aged in sherry oak barrels, or oak barrels that sherry has been matured in. Sherry, the liqueur, the Spanish fortified wine. And you can actually taste the sherry in this Virginia Perique blend. I love it. It's got a good kick to it. It's not as strong as Irish Flake. It's probably on par with something like, strength-wise, with University Flake. It's good strength to it. Lovely, lovely blend. And I will definitely be buying more. So that's been the blend of the week for me. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope to make a video closer to Christmas. Maybe not. I wish you all the best on this festive season. How happy am I? Thank you very much, Tom. You're a top man. Bye bye.